So in my last video, I showed how to set up a virtual machine using Virt Manager in Fedora. One thing you might want to do is if you have virtual machines that are running services that you want to be accessible from the external network, the way Virt Manager sets up the default network isn't really conducive to that kind of a setup. So if we look in Virt Manager here, and then we right-click on localhost, details, and network interfaces. Virtual networks. You can see that there's a default virtual network here. And if we expand the IPv4 configuration, you'll see that there's a private subnet configured here with NAT forwarding. And so what that allows is for the VMs to get outside, but unless you configure IP forwarding and firewall rules and a bunch of crazy stuff on the host, nothing from the outside can get to the VMs. And so if you're hosting a web server off a VM, then that's probably not what you want. What you probably want is Ethernet bridging so that the VMs can be on the same network as the host. So I'm going to demonstrate how to do that real quick. So what we need to do is we need to get to the network manager control panel. There's a lot of different ways to do this. So I'm just going to do it this way. Once we get in here, we see our wired Ethernet connection here with our network configuration. What we need to do is we're going to take this configuration and move it over onto an Ethernet bridge and then make this wired connection a port on that bridge. So the first step here is to erase this profile for the wired connection. So the way we do that is click on the little gear icon down here and then go to the reset and hit forget. And you'll see that the configuration is wiped out for the wired connection. Now this will kill your internet connection, so just be aware of that. When you hit the plus sign, we can add a bridge. This is a little trick that I just figured out with Network Manager after this is the second take of this video. I hit this problem. You need to make this connection name and the interface name the same, otherwise a virtual machine manager won't pick up on it. Another thing you want to do is disable SDP. Unless you've got some weird configuration going on your network, this will only delay your bridge coming up and can cause some weird behavior, so I just disable it. Then under bridged connections, click add, go to Ethernet type, and then under device MAC address, you'll see your physical Ethernet adapter here. Click on that, then go to the general tab and go to automatically connect to this network when it's available, and then click save. If you have any non-DHCP IPv4 settings, you can set them up here. Basically, you're gonna wanna copy your configuration from your what used to be your wired connection. After you've done that, you can hit save, and you'll see that the wired connection comes up, it's on, it's got a hardware address, but no IP configuration. You go to the bridge and it has the IP address, the route, the DNS, and then you see bridge slaves wired. That means that this wired connection is a port on this bridge now. So now what we can do is we can hop over to Virtual Machine Manager, and if you right click, go to details and then network interfaces, you'll see that our bridge zero is now one of the network interfaces that Virt Manager is aware of. So if you create a new virtual machine, then here on the last panel, step 4 of 4, if you do it a different way, it might be step 5 of 5. You can expand advanced options here, and you'll see that the network interface card that's going to configure for the VM is going to be on bridge zero, not on this default NAT network. And once that VM comes up, it'll get an IP address from the DHCP server on your external network. And then firewall permitting inside the VM, you can host services on there, and the host system, the bridge on the host system, will just act like an Ethernet switch to the external network for your VMs.